You know, in some of these communities that we're talking about where there's some problematic issues, they could be our next leader in that generation and actually like channel that energy of leadership and passion and all that kind of amazing stuff that could be used for positivity rather than negativity.
Rest assured, in the shadows we will find a place where you and I reside. The rest of the world can watch wild.
Hi, I'm Ecca Vandal, and I was born in South Africa, and I'm an artist from Melbourne.
$200 in this pocket with a brand new plan. Nothing can stop him, even immigration, man.
My parents are Sri Lankan. They were born and raised in Sri Lanka and raised my two sisters in Sri Lanka for most of their life. We moved here mainly because my family were in South Africa at the time. It was quite a lot of political turmoil happening in South Africa with the apartheid. So my family decided to move to Australia. Kind of adapting to Australian culture was a big, big thing, especially being a teenager in Australia.
You're my blood, you're my drug, you're my thrill. Wouldn't trade you for nothing. They think I'm gone, even family don't get everything that surrounds me. Fades into darkness when I.
I think that I was okay with being different. I think there was a time in my life where I figured out, okay, I am different and I look different to people, I sound different to other people. How do I feel within myself? And I think that's something that took me a little bit of time to kind of work out.
You push me to fail, drive me to
I always love music. Music's in my blood. It's part of my culture, it's part of my roots. The difference though is that a lot of my family are musically talented. So it was sort of viewed as a hobby. It was sort of viewed as, oh yeah, you're good at that, so is everybody else in the family. But it was a massive thing for me to actually view it as a career and have people look at me and go, oh well, you can actually do this if you discipline yourself and go and pursue it and study. That was a very big shift in my mind. My two sisters are older than me, quite a bit older than me, so I think they're both role models as strong women, intelligent women, creatively talented. They both really encouraged me to make some massive decisions in my life.
You lead me blind to the water, you're my anchor.
So I kind of had to go against the grain with that and decide to do this, and I think that I've made a really good decision. I still stand by it.
You ain't that clever, cause
there's one specific role model that I go to now is like a mentor to me that I constantly can pick up the phone and ask him questions, and so that's really important that I can go to them, and it's really cool to be accepted just as I am. I reckon we need to bring back all ages gigs so that there's actually more fun things for young people to do, because like in the late 90s there was a lot of punk rock shows that were all ages. The best part about playing live, I find, is looking out into the crowd and I can see lots of different people, lots of different types of people, lots of different communities all in the one room. Music can blur those lines that divide us, then that's a beautiful thing. I think extracurricular activities is really important. Things like sports, things like music programs, choirs, dance groups, community groups are really important because you find your tribe, you find people who understand you. I'd love to hear about how you got into dance.
I was in year seven, mm-hmm. and I had a girls dance crew called Culture Queen. I just loved it so much because I felt accepted no matter where I was from. Like, kids love to dance and sing and have fun and play sport, and if you don't offer these services to them, they're just going to be disengaged and they're not going to have fun really.
Exactly.
Yeah.
What drives you to not go and hang out with them but to actually go and be disciplined and train?
So what initially inspired me to dance was like YouTube videos. At first I was watching like Michael Jackson. So I wanted to show the younger generation that you can do something with your life, like something positive, instead of doing drugs, wow. smoking weed. But I want to create my own destiny. I want to be different to my community. I want to bring something new, something positive to me, the community.
Wicked.
Yeah.
That's awesome, man.
From my perspective, youth and gang violence is perceived with a lack of understanding, basically. It's viewed in a negative way when it doesn't need to be. Sometimes people don't actually go to the root of the problem and go, okay, how can we actually help this and turn this into a positive? I feel really passionate about that, that you know they have potential and that there's so much great stuff that can come out of that if we just take it, if we spin it in a different direction and go, cool, well you're actually really great at that thing. You're a leader and everyone wants to follow you. So how can we use that skill set? How can that be transferable? Yeah, I feel really passionate about that.
Our voice is a voice of change.